advertising without posters is like fishing without worms. The Hatch poster, though, kicks with a louder boot when it blows the door down of advertising. I'm Jim Sheradin. I'm the manager here. I run one of America's oldest letterpress printing shops since 1879 right here in downtown Nashville. Walk in our door, you might see Kathy saying hello, or you might see a cat sleeping on the mat. You're also going to see so many letterpress posters, and that's what we do here. We design and print posters using this wonderful archive here. Look around on the walls, you're going to see posters from 1928, posters from 2008, and a little bit in between. In the multiple decades that I've been here, the staff has grown. Now we're up to about 10 folks that work here. We have interns from all over the United States, sometimes from Europe. They could come from Switzerland, or you could be from Salina, Kansas, where I'm from. Our cats are here because we had a rodent problem, and their names are Huey, but I call them Whiskers, and the other one is Meow, because the big kitty needs a little kitty cat girlfriend. So here we are in the 21st century. What makes Hatch a unique place is the fact that everything is done here by letterpress, by hand, hand crank, hand inked, hand trimmed, hand wrapped, and we call the customer from a rotary telephone. We balance not only our responsibilities as designers and printers, but we also have a responsibility to the heritage of the shop. I like to think that we're in a working museum here. The blocks are historically gorgeous, wonderfully carved. We can make them come to life again by putting ink on them, keeping dust off the backs, and that's our goal here, is to not only honor the heritage of the shop, most importantly though, we are able to create posters every day, all day long here, using this wonderful living archive.
Jim's motto is preservation through production. So we still keep everything in motion. We don't just let it sit around. We don't sell it off. We keep using it, which is what's really neat, and that's what puts us out there in the world. And so I would say that I design and print posters in very simple terms, because that's what we do every day, is we talk to clients, we design posters, and then we print them. But of course it is more complex than that. You know, when you go into it, you say that you use wooden and lead type in order to typeset posters, and then you place it in a press bed, ink up the press, and then roll each poster through one at a time. And it helps to explain that it's a very labor-intensive process, that from beginning to end, it takes at least a week, if not two, from getting the job and looking at the copy and thinking about it for a few minutes to printing the poster. So that helps people to understand how it differs from offset printing or digital, which you can have in 3 days. We have 7 presses here in the shop that we use on a daily basis. They range from very small presses that we use for things like postcard backs and envelopes, to medium-sized proof presses, to a fully automatic press that we do all of our larger jobs on. They've been pretty much the same design since Gutenberg invented it, so not that much has changed. It's still the same principle. I'm registering each poster with these grippers right here at the top of the cylinder and with this guide right here, and that keeps everything lining up just right because I have already printed the first color, so it's essential that the second color fall into the right place. The middle cylinder is what applies the pressure, and then it inks on the way back. It's a pretty straightforward machine. Even though I apply the ink by hand, the rollers continuously oscillate, and there's a bottom roller that keeps them rotating, and that keeps the ink consistent in both color and quantity.
Historically, posters were used for advertising, and that's its main purpose. But they're also used as a commemorative item. They remind you of a specific event, whether it's a wedding or that great concert that you just saw. And there's something that you want to take home and take care of. If you walked in and looked over our shoulder and at the clipboard of work, and you'd see, gosh, they do 600 plus jobs a year and entertain over 50,000 people that walk in the front door, that you can get a letterpress wedding invitation, you can get a letterpress save the date, You can get a letterpress baby announcement, or you can get a Bruce Springsteen poster done here. And our customers could be any of the above. The venue, the client, the celebrity, a little of everything. You look around at all of our contemporary customers and it's easy to ask, well, how come the shop is so popular? I think it's because we pull the same drawers open this year that were pulled open 70 years ago. It could be Bessie Smith, it could be the Beastie Boys. There's a heritage that we try to relate to the customer and to the viewer when they see a Hatch poster. The imagery in the shop is so distinct. It's a combination of old wood blocks that we have here. And while we don't introduce new typefaces because I don't want to pollute the integrity of the original archive, we're all carving new blocks all the time. Something to add, something new, and create today's archive for the next generation. The monoprints are a personal expression of what I can do to help keep the blocks living in the shop. They came from the happy accidents, from cleaning the blocks with the paper, seeing all this beautiful imagery. The goal is to create a kaleidoscope of color, create a new curve for the archive here at Hatch. I call this the quilted one sheet. So this is 25 sections of different wood blocks. Once you get the idea, it's more math than anything else. Each one is unique, so that's why I call them monoprints. But there are similarities in a few of them. Preservation through production, even if it's the production of one. All these blocks are welcome again, back into the eyes of all of us folks in the 21st century. You see a very organic poster, you see a very organic style of printing and design technology that's a touchstone to the way posters were made in the old days. We are able to produce a wonderful product that is unusual in the United States, in the world, a wonderful letterpress poster based on a shop that started in 1879.